Commodore John Bailey presents. The 2020-2021 Back to School Night Virtual Edition. Teachers can do virtually anything.
Love of all was happening to me. up a wall inside of me.
Hi, everyone. Good evening, John Berry family. I would like to welcome you to our virtual back to school night. My name is Ms. Cox, and I am proud to serve as the assistant principal for the 2021 school year. This is my fifth year leading at John Berry, and out of all my years, this year definitely has brought the most challenge due to the COVID-19. Nevertheless, I can assure you we have a team of dedicated leaders and dedicated teachers who are working diligently to support your child. Many of them spent all summer long preparing and planning to make sure that this experience was worthwhile. We hope that this school year will be wonderful for all of our families. We are here to serve you. We will continuously do our best to effectively communicate, since technology right now is our best friend at the moment. As you probably can tell, I'm actually using my cell phone to record this video. So many of us have learned how to navigate in these very uncertain times. We encourage you to utilize all of the resources available that are posted on our Berry website. We also encourage you to visit our Facebook and Instagram pages. And last but not least, make sure you stay connected with your child's teacher. Tonight, our teachers are going to provide you with important information and updates, many of which they've communicated through Class Dojo and also on the Google Classroom. So please make sure you pay attention and you absorb all the information and you ask as many questions as you like. We are here to serve and support you. Your child's teacher will give you any additional updates with information regarding our various platforms. We hope that you and your child has an outstanding school year. We hope that this visit will be wonderful, and we want you to know that we cannot do this work without you. We thank you, we support you, and we hope that you stay well and you stay connected. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful back to school night.
Good evening and welcome to Berry's first virtual Title I back to school night. My name is Principal Katedra Argo, and I am so happy to be here with you tonight. Tonight I will be presenting our back to school night Title I presentation. I want you to look closely at Berry's models. One of our models is changing the narrative, and the reason that we chose changing the narrative is we want Berry at 59th and Race to be a school that you wait in line to get your student in. We want Berry to be a school where everybody chooses to send their children to Berry and not send their child just because it's the zip code where they live. Also, this is our more drastic, emergent motto: lead, follow, or get out of the way. And my reason behind choosing this model is you're either a good leader, you're either a good follower, good leaders follow, or you're just simply in our way. What is Title I? Title I is the federal government that provides funding to every state for schools. So when we think about fair funding formulas and we think about monies for schools, Title I has a formula that gives us money based on low income status and students and what type of designation your school is. Each spring, we look at the budget and we decide with parents in our community how we're going to spend our Title I funding. Our school needs your help with our parent and family engagement, our school parent compact, and our school-wide plan. And it also drives our school budget. When you think about the School District of Philadelphia and how we receive input in the parental compact and engagement policy of the school district, if you would like to be involved on the larger scale of the district, please call our Office of Family and Community Engagement at 215-441-80. During this school-based parent and family engagement policy, we discuss how parents can be involved in the school process. We also provide assistance to parents that will support our student and academic achievement. We help build parents' capacities and building resumes, operating the school net, operating our scholar systems, operating our platforms. We also develop parents in the evaluation of the school engagement policy. When you think about the school and parent compact, it talks about the goals and responsibilities of the school and providing a quality education for every student, meaning your child, every child at Berry. The compact also states Well, how can you help us as parents? What type of gap we will bridge and how we can support one another with your scholar? When we think about Title I designations, Pennsylvania gives total designations to different schools. You have the Comprehensive Student and Improvement Designation, Targeted Support Designation, and Additional Support. As you guys know, Barry has been a part of the Acceleration Network for the last 5 years, where we have received funding for being an acceleration school that needed a little more resources to get us going. The good thing about this is we have exited the Acceleration Network. We're now a part of Learning Network 5, and we are currently non-designated. Does that mean we deserve more funding? Absolutely. But we were so graciously able to keep some of our funding from the Acceleration Network. But we should be a designated area because we do have some of the qualifications of the low-income status to receive some designation. When we think about our school-wide plan, it talks about the baseline. What is the data now? Our goals. How are we going to get there? And our plan. What are we going to do to get there? And how are we going to monitor that? So we have to review and revise. If what we're doing is not working, we have to continuously change that. When we think about our school-wide plan, currently we think about attendance. Barry's attendance at March 13th when we left with the COVID was at 39.26% of students that had 95 or better attendance, percent better attendance. Parents, we need you to get your students here every day on time. We need you to have your students present on time. The babies need just support to get in here every day to learn. When we think about climate and culture, we had 95.97% of our students with zero suspensions. The reason that we had that low number, not to say we don't have discipline issues, we just use restorative practices and progressive discipline to support your scholars. When we think about the academic growth, we have math, where we were at a positive 0.133%. We were at an ELA, a minus 1.88%, but that's still kind of, you know, we're working and evolving. In science, we took a little dip in fourth grade science, so we know we need to focus on that area. And eighth grade science, we took a little negative 0.85 dip, and we know that we need to put some resources in place and some progress monitoring to make sure that we increase instead of decrease. When we look at the plan, SDP wants us to be 95% or better, but the end of the 18-19 school year, we were at 21.19% of students that were 95% or better. We're aiming for 31.19%. I know that seems like a small percentage, but we have to make gains that are manageable and measurable, and so we would love to exceed this number, but we need you to help with that. As far as suspensions, we know that our scholars know how to behave. We know that they support our positive behavior systems. So we have faith that we could control the suspension number. But we need you parents to assist us with that. As far as academics, we look at about a 5 to 10% increase, and that may seem modest, but we have some students that who achievement gaps are larger than others, and we want to make sure that we take all our time to look at the interventions as a team to make sure that we're addressing all of your students' needs. And we need you again, parents. If you want us to assist your students a little further, please contact us. We could talk about how we could be a part of the MTSS process or the RTII process. When we think about the school budget, I want you to know that 1% of our budget is always set aside for parental involvement, and we always call you in to find out how should we spend that money. So this school year in our budget, we took the 1% of our budget and we spent it on our school improvement person, that our liaison that assists with our school improvement plan, our SISL, Ms. Freeman. We all know she does a wonderful job at bridging the gap between school and family, so we spent a bulk of our money in buying that position. When we think about the rest of the money that's left, we talk about literacy and math interventions and programs and just instructional aids for parents. Having the workshops and the things that you guys can have within the workshops that we had last school year and this school year, we'll start virtually improving parents and what they need to do to assist their scholars. So when we think about what do we do to engage you as parents, we have parental workshops. We have SAC involvement. Parents, we really need for you to join the SAC. You'll hear more about that at a later date. We have volunteering opportunities, criminal and child abuse clearances that are free of cost with the school district. We have communication and English, and we always talk about the calendar school messenger. When we think about communication, we have Facebook. Please join us on Facebook at John Barry. Please join us on Instagram at John_Barry_Bulldogs. And your teachers will be communicating via Dojo. We also have parent surveys. We need your input. We also have school events, math and literacy workshops with Ms. Freeman, and report card conferences that it's imperative that you attend. When we think about state certified teachers, we need all of our teachers to be state certified by passing the praxis, having a bachelor's degree, and be assigned in the areas that they're certified in. Also, our paraprofessionals, such as our educational assistants, as well as our special education assistants, they also have to be highly qualified. When they are not qualified, you have the right to know, and the school sends home a letter. After being educated by school for 4 weeks, if the teacher is not certified, then you have the right to know. We also have our PSSA state standards, our report cards that are November, February, and April. We look forward to you attending. And we have our curriculum, Pearson and Envisions for math, ReadyGen and Collections for ELA. We need your support at home. Our school needs you. We need for you to take advantage of everything that Title I has to offer. We need you to assist with this parent, home, school gap. We also need for you to send your babies to school every day to assure that they're making adequate progress. You, your child, and our school can be a winning team. Thank you and have a great evening.
Follow, get out the way, get out the way, get out the way.